Let's look at naming esters, a carboxylic acid derivative in priority group. And so if the ester is the highest priority group in our compound, so up the chart, carboxylic acids and anhydrides are higher than esters. Other than that, they are going to win out as the priority group. Then we use the priority suffix oate. And if the ester is not the highest priority group, and say it is lower than carboxylic acid or anhydride, then we'll name the compound as a carboxylic acid and then or anhydride, and then use the ester subordinate groups if the carbonyl is first, an alkoxy carbonyl group, or if the oxygen is attached to the parent chain, an alkanoyl oxy. So let's do some examples here. We are still following our order of operations. We're going to be circling the parent chain, writing the names of any subordinate groups that intersect that chain, numbering the parent chain, and then assembling the name, checking for stereochemistry. All right, so looking at a simple ester, just to illustrate the differences in other classes of organic compound, the ester, we're gonna see, has a portion of the parent chain, carbon-to-carbon parent chain, that contains, and I guess more appropriately, we could include the other oxygen as well here as our parent chain, okay? But there'll be an alkyl group here off of that oxygen that is taken as a separate word in the name of the ester. So when we go to actually form the name of this ester here, we're going to type ethyl out front as a separate word. From there, if we number our parent chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, we take our prefix for the alkyl parent portion of the chain, so that's a pent because of 5 carbons, and then pentanoate because it's an ether, an ester, excuse me, so ethyl pentanoate. If there's more than one ester present in your compound, and it is the highest priority group, then you're going to include both of them on the two ends of the parent chain as part of your parent chain. And it won't matter unless there are groups substituted in here. We'll see an example in a moment where there are. Which way we number, we're going to get the same name, 1 to 5, left to right, or right to left. What I did want to point out here is that here we've got two alkyl groups, two different alkyl groups, on the oxygens of our two esters. And so when we go to put this name together, we want to put those in alphabetical order of their names. So ethyl first, separate word, methyl, separate word, pentane in this case, instead of pentandioate, an E is placed in there to separate the consonants when the prefix is used. So instead of pentanoate, we now have pentanedioate. And that's pretty consistent throughout systematic nomenclature to add that E to separate consonants in the suffixes of the parent chain, pentanedioate. What if we have two esters and a group situated on the parent chain somewhere? So here's our parent chain, including our esters. Write the names of our groups, methyls. Well, notice the alkenes completely contained within the parent chain, they get special treatment. Alkenes and alkynes do. And so typically in the name, if all alkene, alkyne, and a priority group are present, you see 3 suffixes used in the name. Ene, ine, and then whatever that highest priority group suffix is. And so here, we're going to number the chain in order to lower that alkene. So left to right gives us a 2 instead of a 3 on the alkene. When we put the name together, let's see if we can get that there, perfect. We're going to see dimethyl. There's 2 of them, separate word. They're connected to oxygen. They go out in front as a separate word. And then instead of pentan like we had before, pentanoate, we have a pentene oate here, and so this is going to be, but we need a locant for that, a pent-2-ene, pent-2-ene, bring the E in because of the dioate. Okay, if it was just One ester, we wouldn't need that E. We just have pentene O8. But because we do have two, that O8 has an extra consonant there, so ene dioate, to separate those two, we add an EN. And we don't need numbers for the ester carbonyl carbons because they are automatically going to be at the ends of the parent chain. You can't number through an ester. It has to be at one end or the other. So dimethyl pent 2 ene dioate. We could alternatively say dimethyl 2 pentene dioate. When you're dealing with esters, we want to place a stereochemistry tag for the parent chain between the ester names of the groups on the oxygen and the parent chain. And so I'm going to put E in here for that double bond, E pentuene dioate, in between. If that stereochemistry were in the alkyl groups, we would put the E out in front, but it's not here. It's in the parent chain, so it goes connected to that parent chain. Okay. Well, what if we do have a higher priority group present? And in both of these examples, we're going to have examples of where the carboxylic acid is greater than the ester here. And so now we're going to name these compounds as carboxylic acids. And so I'm going to circle the parent chain. The highest priority group must be in the parent chain, as discussed in a separate video for picking the parent chain. One, two, three carbons. And when the carbonyl is connected to the parent chain, the pre-2013 rules say to name this as an alkoxy carbonyl. So this would be alkoxy's methoxy here because of the one methyl group. So that's methoxy carbonyl group. That's just like if it were a chloro group. It's a methoxy carbonyl group. So we would call this as a full name here a 3-methoxycarbonyl propanoate. Three carbons in the parent chain makes it a propanoate. Okay, I know there are common names for some of these simple esters. We're learning systematic nomenclature, so we're going to stick to the systematic name. Now, if there's a pre-2013 name, there can also be a post-2013 name. And the new naming rules proposed by the IUPAC system are to take this out to the longest carbon-carbon chain possible, no matter what. And so we would include the carbonyl of that subordinate ester in the counting of the parent chain. One, two, three, four now in the chain. So what that's going to do is that's going to change the parent chain name from a propanoate to a butanoate. Okay, now we've got four carbons in. And now we can split up this methoxycarbonyl into an oxo group and just a methoxy group. Okay, so we get rid of the more complicated name and simplify the names of the groups just a little bit. So what we end up with in alphabetical order is a 4-methoxy, 4-oxo-butanoate as our alternative name for the ester. My class gets to choose either system you want to name it with, pre or post 2013. Either is good for me. Okay, the other scenario is if the oxygen, see before we had the carbonyl of the ester connected to the parent chain. Well, what if we had a higher priority group than an ester, a carboxylic acid? I'm going to circle the parent chain like we always do, the longest carbon to carbon chain and the highest priority group in the chain. And then we're going to name the groups. There's a chloro. Well, now we've got an oxygen connected to that parent chain. And so we're going to call it an alkyloyl oxy. So the alkyl part is ethane. It's an ethanoyl oxy group attached to the parent chain. One, two, and three. We can put this name together with a 3-chloro first, alphabetically, and then a 3-ethanoyl oxy propanoic acid. Okay, so we're naming it as a carboxylic acid because that's the highest priority group. You should find this very similar for naming these ethanol oxy groups, okay, to naming acid halides. So if we had an acid halide, this would be ethanol bromide. So ethanol oxy just means there's an oxygen connected and it's a group, not a bromide, not a full group or not a full compound as a subordinate group on a larger parent chain.